Postal 2!
Do you enjoy running errands for your wife?
Do you enjoy shooting people in the face?
Don't you love hacking people's limbs to bits with an iron shovel?
Seek therapy.
Postal 2 is the sequel to the 1997 isometric twin-stick mass shooter simulator Postal. Those are words. Postal 1 was shrouded in a lot of controversy back in the day since it started a white man in a trench coat shooting police officers since he didn't want to pay his taxes. The mentality at the time was, if my child plays the bad, that child becomes the bad. Now, I don't know anyone who played this game and thought,
yup, I will pay my monetary dues to society, not me.
And then I'll embark on a suicide mission where the objective is to go shoot up some random ghetto town in a state that most people outside of the United States have never heard of.
Now, call me a bit of a pessimist, but doesn't that sound- Postal 2 was a direct follow-up to the controversy surrounding Postal 1. Okay, get ready to spot the satire. Okay, get ready.
Postal 1, tax evasion, violent shootout with the police.
Postal 2, argument with your wife, don't forget a rocky road, you get fired from your job, run errands, okay, great.
In Postal 2, you play as a balding ginger, running all sorts of errands for his wife. You know, the usual stuff, like showing up to work, buying goat milk, getting your uncle's favorite birthday present, you know, all that jazz.
Great, now here's the issue.
I show up to my new job and immediately get fired, and now a bunch of anti-violent video game protesters are shooting up the place. Okay, fine. Okay, great, so I don't have a job, therefore I don't have money, so I try shoplifting the goat milk, and then the cashier pulls a gun out from behind the register. So, now I have to fight through him and his army of machine gun wielding wives. Okay.
So, what about delivering my uncle's present? So on Wednesday, I have to acquire an autographed copy of Gary Coleman's latest book. On Thursday, I have to bribe Mr. Crotchy with said autographed copy so I can acquire his sold-out Crotchy toy from him. Okay, fine. Or you can just shoot him. On Friday, I go to give Uncle Dave his favorite birthday present.
I'm sorry, did I mention the part where he was secretly running a cult compound? Now the ATF is raiding the place, and they have it surrounded, and then when I gave him the present, they begin to open fire. Okay, normal game.
Postal 2 takes place in the open world of Paradise, Arizona. Now, something you'll notice right off the bat is that you cannot traverse Paradise by car or vehicle. No. Your car broke down, so you have to get from one errand to another by foot. Traversal is one of the key elements to your enjoyment of Postal 2. In most games, an open world is used as a hub to unlock more of the game as you progress. In Postal 2, the open world is the game, and you progress by using the open world. In Postal 2, everyone and their mothers has several guns stored up their buttocks, ready to be used at all times. Now that, combined with Postal 2's like 50 guns and huge arsenal of weapons, can create for all sorts of violent mayhem. Oh yeah, the weapons in this game are astounding. You know, you have your basics, you know, ranging from a handgun, an automatic rifle, a shotgun, some grenades, you know.
And then you have a diseased, severed cow head and a napalm launcher and a flying machete and the shotgun. It blows stuff up.
On top of that, the map design is damn good too.
Exploration is very rewarding. Sometimes you'll find cash, you know, sometimes weapons, healing items, a sex dungeon.
Each map flows right into the next one seamlessly, making basic traversal a piece of cake. Every design choice feels deliberate. Nothing feels out of place or out of line.
Brief summary.
Postal 2 is actually a disgusting game. It's Dodgy Art style, it's lowbrow humor. It's just bottom of the barrel scum. But it's $10. Buy it.